Hello mga Cockpit Angels! Welcome back for another Maxinate episode. This is Teacher Mika
and this is Teacher Joymi.
For our Week 5 lesson on first quarter, we will discuss the operations on rational numbers.
After going through this module, you are expected to perform operations on rational numbers. In our previous discussion, we learned how to convert rational numbers from one form to another, the conversion from fraction to decimal, and from decimal to fraction. Today, we will discuss operations on fractions and on decimals, specifically, the addition and subtraction of similar fractions and mixed numbers, addition and subtraction of dissimilar fractions and mixed numbers, multiplication of fractions, division of fractions, addition and subtraction of decimals, multiplication of decimals, and division of decimals.
Let's get started. To add or subtract similar fractions, add or subtract the numerators. Write the sum or difference over the common denominator and then reduce the answer to lowest term if needed. Here are the examples. Letter A, add 3/5 and 1/5. Solution: 3/5 plus 1/5 is equal to 3 plus 1 for the numerator, then copy the common denominator, which is 5. So we have 4/5. Therefore, 3/5 plus 1/5 is equal to 4/5. Letter B, subtract 4/10 minus 2/10. Solution, 4/10 minus 2/10 is equal to 4 minus 2 for the numerator, which is 2, over, copy the common denominator, which is 10. So we have now 2/10. Then when simplified or have their lowest term, we have 1/5. So therefore, 4/10 minus 2/10 is equal to 1/5.
To add or subtract mixed numbers with similar fractional parts, first, add or subtract the whole numbers. Then, add or subtract the numerators and write the sum or difference over the common denominator. Finally, reduce the answer to lowest term if needed. For example, add 4/1/9 and 5/2/9. So first, we will just add the whole numbers which are 4 and 5. And for the fractional part, we will add the numerators 1 and 2 and then copy the common denominator which is 9. Simplifying, we have 9/3/9 or 9 1/3 in lowest term. Next example, subtract 23 and 7/28 minus 2 and 2/28. So we will just subtract the whole numbers 23 minus 2, that will be 21. And then we will subtract also the numerators 7 and 2, that will be 5. And copy the common denominator, which is 28. Since this is already in lowest term, then 21/5/28 will be the final answer.
Next, to subtract a fraction from a whole number, just multiply the denominator to the whole number, then subtract it by the numerator. The answer will be your numerator. Then copy the denominator of the given fraction. Reduce the answer to lowest term if needed. Here are the examples. Letter A, subtract 5 minus 2/3. Solution, 5 minus 2/3. Multiply the denominator and the whole number, so 3 times 5, which is 15, then subtract the numerator, which is 2. So 15 minus 2 is equal to 13 over, copy the denominator, which is 3. Therefore, 5 minus 2/3 is equal to 13/3 or 4 1/3. Letter B, subtract 9 minus 3 3/16. For example B, we first convert the mixed number into an improper fraction. Then we will apply the same rule we did with example letter A. So to convert, 16 times 3 is equal to 48 plus 3, which is 51. Then copy the denominator, which is 16. So solution, 9 minus 51 over 16. Following the same rule a while ago, 16 times 9 minus 51 over 16. So, 16 times 9 is 144 minus 51, which is 93 over 16. Therefore, we have 93 over 16, or in mixed number, 5 and 13 over 16.
To add or subtract the similar fractions, change them to similar fractions by finding their least common denominator or LCD. Then apply the rule in adding or subtracting similar fractions. Reduce the answer to lowest term if necessary. For example, add 1/3 and 2 over 4. Step 1, find the LCD by identifying the LCM of 3 and 4. The multiples of 3 are 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, and so on. The multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, and so on. Therefore, 12 is the LCM of 3 and 4. This will be the LCD. Step 2, rewrite the addends as similar fractions having the LCD as their denominator. That is, 1/3 is equivalent to 4 over 12, and 2 over 4 is equivalent to 6 over 12. And lastly, we add the similar fractions 4 over 12 plus 6 over 12. So we will just add the numerator 4 and 6, which is equal to 10. And then we copy the common denominator, which is 12. Simplifying or reducing the lowest term is equivalent to 5 over 6. Therefore, 1 over 3 plus 2 over 4 is equal to 5 over 6. Next example, subtract 3 over 6 minus 1 over 5. First, we find the LCD by identifying the LCM of 6 and 5. Since the LCM of 6 and 5 is 30, then we will use 30 as the LCD. Next, rewrite the addends as similar fractions having the LCD as their denominator. That is, 3 over 6 is equivalent to 15 over 30 and 1 over 5 is equivalent to 6 over 30. Then, subtract the similar fractions 15 over 30 minus 6 over 30. Just subtract the numerators 15 and 6, that is equal to 9, and then copy the common denominator, which is 30. Reducing the lowest term will be equal to 3 over 10. Therefore, 3 over 6 minus 1 over 5 is equal to 3 over 10.
Next, to add or subtract mixed numbers with the similar fractional parts, change the fractional parts to similar fractions by finding their LCD. Affix the whole numbers, then apply the rule in adding or subtracting similar fractions. Reduce the answer to lowest term. Let's have some examples. Letter A, add 2 and 3 fifths and 1 and 2 over 8. Here are the steps. Step 1, find the LCD by identifying the LCM of 5 and 8. Since the LCM of 5 and 8 is 40, then the LCD is 40. Hence, 3 fifths is equal to 24 over 40 and 2 over 8 is equal to 10 over 40. Step 2, affix the whole numbers. We have 2 and 24 over 40 and 1 and 10 over 40. Step 3, find the sum. Add first the whole numbers, 2 plus 1, which is 3. Next, add the numerator, 24 plus 10 is 34. Then copy the denominator, which is 40. Therefore, 2 and 3 fifths plus 1 and 2 over 8 is equal to 3 and 34 over 40, or 3 and 17 over 20. Letter B, subtract 3 and 1 fourth minus 2 and 1 over 6. Step 1, find the LCD by identifying the LCM of 4 and 6. So the LCD is 12, hence 1/4 is equal to 3 over 12 and 1 over 6 is equal to 2 over 12. Step 2, affix the whole numbers. So we have 3 and 3 over 12 and 2 and 2 over 12. Step 3, perform the operation. Subtract first the whole numbers. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. Next, subtract the numerator. 3 minus 2 is 1. Then copy the denominator, which is 12. Therefore, 3 and 1/4 minus 2 and 1 over 6 is equal to 1 and 1 over 12.
Now try to solve the following worded problems. You may pause the video while answering.
At this point, we are done with the addition and subtraction of similar fractions, dissimilar fractions, and mixed numbers. And so, we will proceed with the multiplication of fractions. To multiply fractions, multiply the numerators to get the numerator of the product. Multiply the denominators to get the denominator of the product. Then, simplify the product if needed. Let's have some examples. Letter A, multiply 2/3 and 1/2. Solution, 2/3 times 1/2 is equal to 2 times 1 for the numerator over 3 times 2 for the denominator. Multiplying it, we have 2 over 6 or 1/3. Therefore, 2/3 times 1/2 is equal to 2 over 6 or 1/3. Letter B, multiply 3/5 and negative 1/2. Solution, 3/5 times negative 1/2 is equal to 3 times negative 1 over 5 times 2. Simplifying it, we have negative 3 over 10. Therefore, 3/5 times negative 1/2 is equal to negative 3 over 10.
A shorter way of multiplying fractions is by using the cancellation method. If cancellation method is done properly, there is no need to simplify the product anymore. The fraction will already be in its lowest term. For example, multiply 2 over 3 and 1 over 4. Step 1, find the common factor of any of the numerators and any of the denominators. In this example, 2 and 4 has a common factor. Step 2, cancel common factors between the numerator and the denominator. In here, the common factor is 2. Hence, 2 divided by 2 is 1 and 4 divided by 2 is 2. And lastly, rewrite the fractions using the uncancelled factors, then multiply. In here, we have 1 times 1 all over 3 times 2, which is equal to 1 over 6. Therefore, 2 over 3 times 1 over 4 is equal to 1 over 6. Next, multiply 3 over 4 and 8 over 9. Same rule will be applied to this example. First, we determine the numerators and denominators which have common factors. In this example, we have 3 and 9, 4 and 8. Next, we cancel the common factors. 3 and 9 has a common factor of 3. Hence, 3 divided by 3 is 1 and 9 divided by 3 is 3. Also, 4 and 8 has a common factor of 4. Thus, 8 divided by 4 is 2 and 4 divided by 4 is 1. Now, rewrite the fractions using the uncancelled factors, then multiply. So we have 1 times 2 all over 1 times 3, which is equal to 2 over 3. Therefore, 3/4 times 8 over 9 is equal to 2 over 3. Note that if cancellation method is not applicable to the given fractions, we go back to the usual method of multiplying the numerator by the numerator and denominator by denominator.
Another examples, letter C, multiply 3/4 by 6. In this example, cancellation method is applicable. Since 4 and 6 has a common factor which is 2, we now cancel it. 4 divided by 2 is 2, then 6 divided by 2 is 3. Then, we write them using the uncancelled factors. So, 3 times 3 over 2. Multiplying it, we have 9 over 2 or 4 and 1/2. Therefore, 3/4 times 6 is equal to 9 over 2 or 4 and 1/2. Letter D, multiply 2 and 2 over 6 by 3 and 1/2. So here is the solution. Rewrite the mixed fractions into improper fractions. 2 and 2 over 6 is 14 over 6. And 3 and 1/2 is 7 over 2. Next, perform the operation using the cancellation method. So looking on our given fraction, we have a common factor between 14 and 2. We then now cancel the common factor. 14 divided by 2 is 7, and 2 divided by 2 is 1. After that, rewrite the uncancelled factors 7 times 7 over 6 times 1. Performing the operation, we have 49 over 6, or in lowest term, 8 and 1 over 6. Therefore, 2 and 2 over 6 times 3 and 1 half is equal to 49 over 6, or 8 and 1 over 6.
Now try to solve the following worded problems. You may pause the video while answering.
Let's proceed to the division of fractions. To divide fractions, find the reciprocal of the divisor and then multiply. Use cancellation whenever possible. Here are some examples. Letter A, 6 over 8 divided by 3 over 4. Solution, step number 1, find the multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of the divisor. The reciprocal of the divisor, 3 over 4, is 4 thirds. The reciprocal of a fraction is obtained by interchanging the numerator and denominator. Step 2. Change the operation from division to multiplication. Multiply the dividend by the reciprocal of the divisor. Use cancellation whenever possible. So from 6 over 8 divided by 3 over 4, it will become 6 over 8 times 4 thirds. Looking for the common factors, 8 and 4 have common factors, as well as 6 and 3. Canceling their common factors, it will result to 4 divided by 4 is 1, 8 divided by 4 is 2, 6 divided by 3 is 2, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. Then, rewrite the fractions using the uncancelled factors, 2 times 1 over 2 times 1. Multiply, we have 2 over 2 or simply 1. Therefore, 6 over 8 divided by 3 fourths is 1. Letter B, 3 divided by 1 half. Solution, get the reciprocal of the divisor, then change the operation from division to multiplication. We have 3 divided by 1 half, it will become 3 times 2 over 1. Lastly, looking on our solution, no need to cancel. We just simply multiply now. 3 times 2 over 1 is equal to 6 over 1 or simply 6. Therefore, 3 divided by 1 half is equal to 6.
Example letter C. 2 over 3 divided by 6. So first, we will just copy 2 over 3 and then change the operation from division to multiplication. Next, we will get the reciprocal of 6, which is 1 over 6. Now, we apply the cancellation method on 2 and 6 since they have a common factor, which is 2. That is, 2 divided by 2 is 1 and 6 divided by 2 is 3. Now, we multiply the uncancelled factors 1 times 1 all over 3 times 3, which is equal to 1 over 9. Therefore, 2 over 3 divided by 6 is equal to 1 over 9. Example letter D. 3 and 4 over 5 divided by 5. First, we have to transform the mixed number 3 and 4 over 5 into an improper fraction, and that would be equal to 19 over 5. Next, we change the operation to multiplication. And lastly, get the reciprocal of 5, and that is 1 over 5. Now, since the cancellation method is not applicable here, we will just multiply the numerators 19 and 1. That is equal to 19 over 5 times 5 for the denominator, and that is equal to 25. Thus, 3 and 4 over 5 divided by 5 is equal to 19 over 25. And this is already in its simplest form.
Letter E, 8 divided by 1 and 1 fourth. Solution, we will convert first 1 and 1 fourth into improper fraction. So from 8 divided by 1 and 1 fourth, it will become 8 divided by 5 over 4. Getting the reciprocal of the divisor and changing division to multiplication, we will now have 8 times 4 fifths. Since there is no common factor to cancel, we'll proceed now to multiplying. 8 times 4 is 32 over 5, or in lowest term, 6 and 2 fifths. Therefore, 8 divided by 1 and 1 fourth is equal to 32 over 5, or 6 and 2 fifths. Letter F, 7 1/2 divided by 1 1/2. Solution: convert first the mixed numbers into improper fractions. So from 7 1/2 divided by 1 1/2, it will become 15/2 divided by 3/2. Getting the reciprocal of the divisor and changing the operation, we have now 15/2 times 2/3. Looking on our fractions, 15 and 3 have common factors as well as 2 and 2. Canceling the common factors, we have 15 divided by 3 is 5, 3 divided by 3 is 1. Numerator and denominator 2 will be canceled, leaving us with only 5 over 1, or simply 5. Therefore, 7 1/2 divided by 1 1/2 is equal to 5.
Now try to solve the following worded problems. You may pause the video while answering.
And we're down to the operations on decimals. To start, let's have the addition and subtraction of decimals. To add or subtract decimals, follow these steps. Step 1, write the decimals in columns. Make sure to align the decimal points of the addends. Step 2, make the number of decimal places equal by annexing zeros to the decimal numbers. Step 3, add or subtract the numbers from right to left in the same way you add whole numbers. Regroup if needed. Align the decimal points of the sum with the decimal point of the addends.
Let's have some examples. Add 0.456, 0.5, and 0.9812. First, we have to write the decimals in columns and make sure that the decimal points are aligned. Then we have to make the number of decimal places equal by annexing zeros to the decimal numbers. Finally, we add the digits from right to left the same way we add whole numbers. Regroup if needed and align the decimal point of the sum with the decimal point of the addends. Hence, 0.456 plus 0.5 plus 0.9812 is equal to 1.9372. Next, subtract 1.9372 from 4.025. So again, we'll just write 4.025 minus 1.9372 in columns, making sure that the decimal points are aligned. Then make the number of decimal places equal by annexing 0 to 4.025. That is 4.0250 minus 1.9372 is equal to 2.0878.
Now, we have the multiplication of decimals. To multiply decimals, multiply them as you would multiply whole numbers. Count the number of decimal places in both factors. The total number of decimal places in the factors should be equal to the number of decimal places in the product. Let's have some examples. Letter A, 0.375 times 346. Solution: we will multiply 0.375 and 346 as if we are multiplying whole numbers, giving us with a product of 129,750. But remember, we have 3 decimal places on our decimal number. So we will move the decimal point 3 units to the left, leaving us with 129.750. Therefore, 0.375 times 346 is equal to 129.750. Letter B, 0.03 times 0.02. To solve, multiply them as you would multiply it like whole numbers. So we have 00006. We will count the decimal places in both factors. 0.03 has 2 decimal places and 0.02 has also 2 decimal places. Moving the decimal point 4 units to the left, we have 0.006 as our final answer.
And to end our discussion today, let's have the division of decimals. To divide decimals, we shall follow the following steps. Number 1, multiply the divisor by a power of 10 or move the decimal point to the right to make the decimal number a whole number. Multiply the dividend by the same power of 10 or move the decimal point to the right as many places as you moved the decimal point of the divisor. Number 2, divide the decimals as you would divide whole numbers. Annex zeros to the right of the decimal point of the dividend until the quotient terminates or the digits in the quotient repeats. And lastly, place the decimal point in the quotient directly above the decimal point of the dividend.
Let's have some examples. Letter A, 84 divided by 1.2. Solution, since the divisor has one decimal place, multiply both the dividend and the divisor by 10. So 84 times 10 is equal to 840 and 1.2 times 10 is equal to 12. Hence, we'll have 84 divided by 1.2 is equal to 84 divided by 12. Using long division, we'll get 70 as the quotient. So, 84 divided by 1.2 is equal to 70. Letter B, 46.5 divided by 1.5. Solution, since the divisor has one decimal place, multiply both the dividend and the divisor by 10. So 46.5 times 10 is equal to 465 and 1.5 times 10 is equal to 15. Thus, 46.5 divided by 1.5 is equal to 465 divided by 15. Using long division, we'll get 31 as the quotient. So 46.5 divided by 1.5 is equal to 31.
Now try to solve the following worded problems for your practice. You may pause the video while answering.
That ends our lesson today. We hope you learned something. See you on our next episode, Kakyut Angels. Keep safe!